Welcome to St. Louis University High School and your virtual Inside SLU visit. We hope this will be a good substitute for giving you a unique look at SLU's campus and what a day at SLU might look like for you. We've got a lot of ground to cover, so sit back, relax, and enjoy your virtual tour of St. Louis University High School. SLU is the oldest high school west of the Mississippi River. It was founded in 1818 and started in a building close to where St. Louis University stands today. In 1923, Mrs. Anna Backer, in memory of her deceased husband George, class of 1869, donated the funds to build SLU's current campus on Oakland Avenue. We're proud of our location in the city of St. Louis and lucky to be so close to major sites, including the St. Louis Science Center and Forest Park. Students arriving for their day are dropped off at the turnaround next to the main entrance, now located in the back of the building. If they're driving, they can park in the St. Louis Science Center lot that is shared by SLU. Our building opens up at 6:30 a.m. for students who need to arrive early, so come on in and join us. We're glad you're here. As the school day begins, breakfast is available for students in our Sci Commons, a space that was formerly the school gymnasium until its renovation in 2012. This space serves for many functions. All of our nearly 1,000 students and faculty can easily fit here for masses and assemblies. All events and large gatherings of our community are held here. But most importantly, this is where the boys eat, socialize, and study if they have a free period. And eat some more. We can head up the stairs now to visit the library. Along this route is a picture history of SLU showcasing images from different decades. We wish we could share all the images now, but SLU is a whopping 200 years old, so it might take a while. Remember, our current campus will be 100 years old in 2024, so while there are a lot of traditional spaces, renovations to upgrade our campus are underway that you'll see a bit later on our tour. Welcome to the library. This space serves many purposes. Of course, it is mainly an area for boys to study and spend their free time engaged in learning. The boys may quietly collaborate in the library or spend time in individual study. The library contains many computers and printers for student use should they need one. Wow, it's busy today. Teachers may choose to have their classes visit the library on occasion, perhaps to work on research or special projects. As you can see, although technology has enhanced learning in many ways, there are still books available to our students and staff. Looks like student council is meeting to plan the week ahead. Our STUCO is made up of boys from different classes who organize activities such as Spirit Week, Mission Week, Dress Down Days, and pep rallies. STUCO manages our Blue Crew, who are responsible for leading and maintaining that signature SLU spirit. Come across the hall into campus ministry. This space serves as the hub of our faith life here at SLU, with many spokes reaching out in different ways. Students who hang out in campus ministry are reminded of the teachings of St. Ignatius that serve as the foundation of Jesuit education and are encouraged to participate in their own faith life through the many activities offered here. While kids generally are in here studying and spending time together, there is also much planning going on for our retreats, service projects, and pastoral programs, all of which are organized or led by students. Across the hall is our old cafeteria space, which is currently being transformed into the J. Anthony and Donna M. Dill Center for Academic Success. This will house our counseling, college counseling, and administrative offices once complete and is scheduled to be finished in the fall of 2020. Now we've come upstairs to the second floor and we'll be entering the science wing. There are two floors that house all science classes and labs in core subjects biology, chemistry, and physics, along with advanced science electives. SLU's Science Wing classrooms have recently been upgraded with new adjustable furniture and technology. Looks like the boys are utilizing laptops from the school's inventory. We're a Mac school all the way. Teachers will often have the laptops available for certain lessons. Now we've gone up the stairs to the third floor of the science wing, where you'll find our physics and chemistry classrooms. Come on in. These rooms are classic SLU and are roomy and bright and conducive to good learning. You can see the boys have a wide view of our campus, Forest Park, and the St. Louis Science Center. Some of these classes now can take place in our new innovation lab, which you'll see a bit later. Let's leave the science wing and stroll down the hall where we can peek into some of our other classrooms. Dr. David Callen has the boys thinking in sophomore English. 95% of our faculty hold advanced degrees, and many are SLU alums. Mrs. Sarah Beckbar seems pleased to watch her seniors engaging. Looks like it's college sweatshirt day, too. Varsity basketball coach Erwin Claggett is ready both on the court and in the classroom teaching social studies. And can anyone guess who's teaching in this English classroom? It's one of SLU's most familiar faces and alumni, Mr. Adam Cruz, class of 2010. The bell is rung and the halls are going to fill quickly. We'll need to move over so we don't get in the way. SLU students are not allowed to carry backpacks. Most carry their books from class to class with occasional stops to their lockers for drop-off or pickup. The boys have 4 minutes to get to each class. All students are required to wear a lanyard ID, which also contains a scan bar for lunch money and their electronic demerit card. We've reached the middle of the morning at SLU. It's activity period, a 45-minute free period between second and third hour classes, and the Psy Commons has filled quickly. The boys can get together to socialize, attend co-curricular club meetings, study, meet with teachers, and again, eat. During activity period, you might catch a glimpse of this guy, Dr. Brock Kesterson. He's our Dean of Students and is responsible for maintaining SLU's disciplined, structured, and safe learning environment. Dr. K talks daily with the boys and connects with them to hear about their school life to ensure they are thriving in our program. All around campus, you'll notice monitors with information for students, faculty, and staff's quick reference. This shows you what our regular school schedule looks like and is always available for the boys' reference. It is also used for us to contact students who may need to report to Dr. K or our counseling office for various reasons. Mr. Cruz will tell you that our dress code is pretty simple. When you come to campus, you'll see firsthand. First rule, collared shirt. Griffin here makes a great model. Next rule, belt. Shirt tucked into nice khaki-style pants. Again, Griffin got it right. As you can see, Griffin has on Sperry's and an approved quarter zip, most likely from the Spirit Shop. Students cannot wear hoodies, athletic shoes, or athletic wear of any kind. There are occasional dress-down days where the dress code will be relaxed per Dr. K. Ah, formal days. When there is mass or an assembly, students are required to wear formal attire. This means blazer or suit with a tie, dress shirt, and shoes. Or you can wear a sweater over your dress shirt and tie with nice slacks and shoes. Now it's time to enter the J Wing, or the Jesuit Wing. This area of the building housed the Jesuit priests who taught at SLU when the building was first opened. This former entrance on Oakland Avenue is now closed to the public. The second floor of the Jesuit Wing houses our studio arts classrooms. Looks like drawing is in session. Can you tell which students are real? Students can take a variety of classes, including ceramics, drawing, and engineering design courses, with plenty of electives in each. The Prep News remains one of the few remaining weekly high school papers in the country and is fully staffed by students. Their office is located next to the art rooms in the J Wing. There is a lot of nostalgia here, as this is their 84th year. You can find Prep News online and on Twitter, too. Thursday nights are deadlines for the paper to be laid out, edited, and sent off to Columbia, Missouri for printing. The staff stays late and shares a meal together. The paper is then delivered very early Friday morning, and the staff then distributes it to the homerooms and offices. Let's head down the back stairs to the first floor of the J Wing while catching a glimpse of our courtyard. The benches surround our Grotto of Mary, where the boys can sit in quiet, reflective time. And you probably can't see beyond that tree, but there are more tables and chairs for students to congregate in this beautiful space, which they do often when the weather allows. This courtyard provides a great space for the boys to get outside and get some fresh air. We'll go inside now to the first floor of the J Wing, where the theology offices and classrooms are located. From there, we can enter the chapel. The chapel provides a beautiful setting where we have class masses, sacraments, and prayer services. All are welcome to join us daily for Mass beginning at 7:30 a.m. A special day is the first Friday of the month when dads and sons are encouraged to attend together. Of course, moms are welcome too. This daily Mass is optional and ends in time for the first homeroom bell at 7:45 a.m. The chapel cannot accommodate our whole student body, so each class has a quarterly Mass here. Every grade level also has weekly homeroom prayer services. Some theology classes utilize the space for different lessons, and the sacrament of confession, along with adoration, is offered here. From the chapel, we'll stroll down to the lower level of our building and into the famous rec room, created by Father Marty Hagen in the 1940s. For quite some time, it has been said that this was actually the largest pool hall west of the Mississippi. I always encourage a little fact check on that. The freshmen utilize this space the most and can often be found here during activity period and after school. This is a good time to talk about our technology formation at SLU. For right now, the boys can only use their iPads or laptops in designated spaces around our building. In the rec room, for example, the boys are encouraged to socialize the old-fashioned way, and the rule is that they leave their devices behind. These signs are hung all around campus indicating which spaces are for technology and which are not. All freshmen will be required to have an iPad and utilize them in a variety of ways both in and out of class. They are allowed to use them in the library and the Psi Commons. However, cell phones must always be kept in lockers for the duration of the school day. Outside of the rec room and down the hall is our weight room. Weights is a PE class, and many of our student body will also utilize this room to work out with their athletic teams. Our athletic training room is a new addition to our health and fitness facilities and features a space for the boys to do strength and conditioning workouts. It also houses our trainers' offices and PT space. You've already seen a lot of the traditional space and a few newer spaces, but this is our newest space, located in the lower level of our campus, the James Guth Costigan Innovation Lab. SLU is proud to have been named by Newsweek magazine as one of the top 500 STEM high schools in the country. This is due to our robust STEM curriculum, learning spaces, and accomplished faculty. This space was created as SLU evaluated what life would be like for our students as we turn 200 years old. Collaborative learning and a very robust space filled with 3D printers and a tech shop have given way to new learning in product development and entrepreneurship. Our shop is also bustling with state-of-the-art equipment and countless opportunities for the boys to channel their entrepreneurial, scientific, and out-of-the-box thinking spirit. A flex classroom next door offers teachers a sharp, high-tech space in which to conduct lessons. On the other side of this room is our robotics area, specifically for our team, club, and mentoring program called the Clavius Project. Exiting the Innovation Lab, we'll stroll down the hall and enter our Performing Arts Wing, located across from the Psi Commons. Our band director, Mr. Pottinger, has the guys playing away in one of our 9 different band programs. There are many opportunities for those who have never played an instrument, to very experienced musicians in orchestra and jazz combos, to musicians who just want to play for fun, kind of like our pep band here. Our band program offers unique training and travel opportunities unrivaled in the St. Louis area, including training with some of the area's top musicians. Shown here is a recent trip to Rome during spring break of 2018. The band was able to play at St. Peter's Square, and look who they met. Next door is the chorus room where the boys develop and rehearse their vocal prowess. Mrs. Addie Aiken proudly directs numerous SLU choral classes and programs from basic to advanced a cappella. Our performing arts wing ultimately leads to our state-of-the-art theater, named after longtime math and drama teacher Mr. Joseph Schulte, class of 1954. Many drama classes happen right here, including a very popular one, acting improv. In this image, the stage was transformed for the 2017 spring production of Mary Poppins. A play will typically be held in the fall, followed by a musical in February, with all sorts of other opportunities in between, like poetry out loud, open mic night, and our cherished tradition, Senior Follies. There's a dance studio above the theater, another fine arts elective class for the boys. SLU is proud that we are one of the few all-boys high schools in St. Louis offering multiple dance classes. Mrs. Anzalone teaches these courses and helps out with all of our theater productions and our sophomore campus ministry programming. Let's cross the Donnie lobby and head over to the field house. It looks like a member of the circus club is taking his time to get some practice in. Welcome to the Donnie Fieldhouse, home of Junior Billikens PE and athletics. The field house serves as a home for Junior Billikens competing in basketball, wrestling, and volleyball, as well as housing offices for the physical education department, the athletic department, and the athletic training staff. Dedicated on September 25, 2009, the facility accommodates 2 full-size basketball courts, 3 team locker rooms, a wrestling practice facility, and seating capacity in the bleachers for over 1,000 fans. Athletic excellence at SLU extends well beyond championships and achievements. It is embodied in the sweat and grind of practice to develop discipline and grow in mind, body, and spirit. It is guided by the care of our coaches and manifests in the way our student-athletes conduct themselves, with pride and humility on and off the field. Our athletic program, distinguished by a strong tradition, offers Junior Bills incredible opportunities with 19 interscholastic sports and excellent facilities on which to play. SLU's Athletic Stadium debuted synthetic turf in 2016. Football, lacrosse, and rugby all compete here. SLU's Soccer Stadium features a 400-meter eight-lane track, lighting for night events, and bleachers. SLU is honored to host the annual Festival of the Miles each year. Sheridan Stadium is home for the Junior Billiken baseball program. This stadium's natural grass and dirt playing surface debuted in 2006. And of course, Forest Park is in our backyard and serves the golf, tennis, cross country, and other teams. Swimmers head right down Oakland Avenue to Forest Park Community College for swimming, diving, and water polo. Thanks for visiting with us today. We hope that it's inspired you to become a Junior Bill. Please consider joining us for one of our many other campus events and visit experiences. Learn more at www.slu.org/admissions.